Andy on camera.
This is something you lack when I'm flat on the back. This is something that I can defy you. So is something you hate or something you wait. Tell me, is there the way to touch you?
Why do you think the name and the legend is already transported?
I don't know. It's so strange that, you know, people have actually heard of it.
Cheers.
I mean, we've been totally amazed to get to America and there's people who are kind of interested. I've been led to believe that no one in America is interested.
Yeah,
and that
British,
not
British
the
musicians die when they come to America.
That's been really nice.
They get eaten alive.
There's no need to be caught. That's something you can't do upon. Why isn't a problem? Nothing we can't solve, so just
relax. I've actually been really surprised coming here how excited a lot of American people that I've met who write for magazines and whatever, work on radio, how excited they are about British fans again, especially, you know, Porter's Head.
Nobody loves me.
Oasis.
Maybe I just wanna fly.
Even Blur, actually,
even
believe it or not.
All the people.
They're actually calling it the new wave of British bands, which is quite strange because it's a different meaning to what new wave means at home. But it's something that I've heard quite a lot, really.
Is it a coincidence that this whole new wave thing has sort of come back at just the right time?
We started it, matey.
Oh, all right.
No coincidence.
Well, was that deliberate, though? Was it,
no,
it just the
it
way
was
it came
totally
out?
Random. You know, you do something and then
I think
suddenly
we were coming from a new angle, which everyone started thinking, oh, that's interesting. So they started writing about it and made it into a scene, which wasn't really a scene, though.
What is it for?
This is sort of like the metaphor for your band when
it
starts
actually
to get out of control.
This is exactly what it's like. This is what it's like once you've got a cover in the end of
the This is our bus driver as well when he's taking us down the
This is our bus driver. He's like, this is what it looks like when you look out the front of the bus at 2 o'clock in the morning.
Oh!
Is the world's worst driver.
I'm not!
Never,
I don't know where you got that from, Jess.
Ever.
I'm a really good driver.
Who drove the band in the very beginning?
Donna.
Me.
Yeah.
I bought the band a van when I first joined them, and the next day I got banned from driving.
Drunken driving. This is really what it's like in the bus at night. It's so funny. We all get into our bunks. The other night, I woke up and I just got out of my bunk to see what was going on. You could just see the white line of the road going like there. The driver sort of battling against the wind and the elements. It's quite scary, really. It's a very strange experience sleeping in those bunks because, like, if you're on a train or a plane or something, you feel like someone out there is kind of looking after you. But when it's just one man driving a huge bus, it's just like...
This is Aerosmith, and you have to shoot your way through the guards to get to Aerosmith.
Why is Aerosmith there then?
You've got to fight your way through to the club, it's coming up.
Oh, get the tank.
I don't really want to see Aerosmith, that's the only problem.
But is it this hard to get into an Aerosmith gig then?
I'll shoot Aerosmith.
Oh, here they go. There you are.
We didn't kill Aerosmith. Sorry about that. We tried.